So, hello everyone. So, today we are going to see the next part of unit number 4, that is analysis of trust. So, before we go for next part, we'll see the definition of trust. You can see in this picture, this is called a trust. The definition is a framed structure consists of number of members connected to each other so as to form a frame to support an external load system. So truss is nothing but a frame, and this frame is made by a number of members which are connected. Now this truss is placed at regular interval, or it is supported at regular interval, and then this frame will support the external load system. Then when the frame is made by the members, these members are connected at the ends, and these members are connected either by the riveting or welding or nut and bolts. You can see in this picture, this is a riveting, this is welding, and this is nut and bolt. Now the material which is used for the truss, generally the steel is used for the truss members, and these members are generally slender in nature. The slender is nothing but the cross section, quite small compared to the length, and generally these are in the form of the angle section. You can see this. This is an angle section, then this is a T section, then this is a I section, okay, this is a C section. So you can see in this picture, and these bars are called two force members because they are either in tension or compression. Then the application of the truss, in the roof of sheds of railway platforms, then industrial sheds, workshop and bridges. So these are some pictures of application of truss. Now these are some main 4 points, that is the about the truss, that is the definition of the truss, then the member, how the members are connected in that truss, then the material of the material which is used for the truss, and the last was the application of truss. The next part is the classification of frames, how the frames are classified. So the frames are classified in plane frame and space frame. So in plane frame, all the members lies in a single plane and the forces act along the plane of the frame. So generally, if you take the example of the plane frame, it is itself a truss, because the truss lies in the members of all the truss lies in a single plane. Now space frame is nothing but a frame in which all the members do not lie in same plane, that is called space frame. So the second picture you can see, this is called a space frame. The next is statically determinate and statically indeterminate frame. So what is meant by the statically determinate frame? The force analysis of members of statically determinate frame can be made by applying equation of static equilibrium. So we know the equation of static equilibrium, that is summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy is equal to 0, and also we know the summation of moment of forces is equal to 0. So using this condition of equilibrium, we can do the force analysis of the members. and in statically indeterminate frame, the equations of static equilibrium are not sufficient to determine the forces. Means the force analysis of members cannot be done by using the equation of static equilibrium. So this is about the statically indeterminate frame. The next part is perfect frame, deficient frame and redundant frame. So before we see the perfect frame, deficient frame and redundant frame, so we'll see the relation between the number of joint J and the number of members in frame. So you can see this is the frame, okay, and in this frame you will see there are total 15 members and 9 joints. Now for simplicity we remove the 3 members A, B, B, C and C. So you can see this, we have to remove this member A, B, B, C and A, C. So what happen when we remove these members and joints? So we will left N minus 3 members and J minus 3 joints. So when we studying the remaining part of this frame, so we can find that for each joint there are 2 members, that is 6 joint, 12 members, okay, because from 15 members we subtract 3 members, it remains 12, and from 9 joints if you subtract 3 joint it will remain 6 joints. So it means for J minus 3 joints, okay, we have twice J minus 3 members. At every joint there are 2 members. So therefore N minus 3 members, we can write as this N minus 3, we can write as twice J, twice in bracket J minus 3. So from that we have to derive this equation. N is equal to twice J minus 3. This is the relation between number of members and number of joints. Now this equation decide whether the frame is perfect frame or deficient frame or redundant frame. Now we will see the perfect frame. Perfect frame is nothing but a perfect frame is composed of minimum number of members required to keep it stable, that is N is equal to twice J minus 3. So we can see in this picture, this is a frame ABC, it has 3 members AB, BC and CA. So as per equation of stable frame, okay, that is N is equal to twice J minus 3. If we put J is equal to 3, so we will get 2 into 3 is 6, 6 minus 3 is 3, that is N is equal to 3. So number of members are here 3, means it is a stable frame or perfect frame. Hence perfect frame always be analyzed by condition of equilibrium. Now this frame we can easily analyze by condition of equilibrium, means we have to use here the condition of equilibrium. Then deficient frame, a deficient frame has less number of members than what required for a perfect frame, that is N is less than twice J minus 3. So we can see this, this is the frame A, B, C, D, that is the number of joints are 4. Now if we put this number of joints 4 in the equation, we will get what? 4 into 2, 2 into 4, 8, 8 minus 3, 5. So number of members required for perfect frame is 5, but here are 4 members. So it is a deficient frame. And therefore, this deficient frame is unstable. So you can see this. This is an unstable member. The next is redundant frame. A redundant frame has more number of members than what required for a perfect frame. Means, suppose this is the frame A, B, C, D. Okay. So here if we put the number of joints 4 here, so 2 into 4, 8, 8 minus 3, 5. So in the, for stable frame, we require 5 members, but here number of members are 6. So it is a redundant frame. So hence redundant frame cannot be fully analyzed by condition of equilibrium. Because in this case, in some joints, the number of unknowns are more than the number of condition of equilibrium. So we cannot do the force analysis. Now the next part is the assumptions which are made while making analysis of truss. So these are some assumptions. So this is very important from some point of view, as well as the last part, that is perfect frame, deficient frame and redundant frame, is also important from exam point of view. You can read these assumptions from your theory notes. So these are very important. Now method of analysis means what, or analysis of truss means what? So analysis of truss means we are finding the member forces. Okay. Now these method of analysis of frame or truss is done by three methods. The first is the method of joint, or we can, other word is method of resolution. Second is method of section, and the third is graphical method. So we will see only these two, that is method of resolution and method of section. Now method of joint or method of resolution. So in this method, every joint is treated separately as a free body in equilibrium. That is, find out the unknown forces in members of truss by taking summation of all vertical forces as well as horizontal forces on the joint and equate to zero. That is, summation fx is equal to zero and summation fy is equal to zero. Means, suppose this is a truss, so every joint we have to treat it separately. Okay. And we have to draw free body diagram for every joint. So for example, this is joint number one. So I am draw a free body diagram for this joint one. Now, so at this joint, the for which forces are acting at this joint? This is the reaction, support reaction. Then this is a member, and the this is a member and the force in that member, as well as this is also another member and the force in that member. Now we can see that this is a concurrent force system. So we know the condition of equilibrium for concurrent force system, that is summation fx is equal to 0 and summation fy is equal to 0. So using two condition of equilibrium, we have to find this member force and this member force. So similarly, we have to draw the free body diagram of each joint, and we have to calculate the member forces. So this is about the method of joint. So whenever there is a question in exam, so you have to write the description of this method of joint, and then you have to explain how the method of joint is, the calculation of method of joint is done. Now we will see the steps which are involved in method of joint. The first step, so when there is a question, okay, so your first step is you have to initially calculate the support reaction. So means you have to first calculate the support reaction. considering the equilibrium of entire truss by applying equation, because we know that the entire truss is a non-concurrent force system. So we have to apply the three conditions: summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy is equal to 0, and summation of moment of is equal to 0. So first you have to use this condition, second you have to use this condition, and third you have to use this condition, and you have to calculate support reaction. Second is, then you have to select a joint at support, or you have to select the joint with only two unknowns, and you have to draw a free body diagram. Then after you draw the free body diagram at any joint, then initially assume that all unknown forces acting towards the joint, that is compressive. Second, then applying summation fx is equal to 0 and summation fy is equal to 0, because when you draw the free body diagram, so it is a concurrent force system, so we are applying these two conditions, summation fx and summation fy, and then we have to find the magnitude and nature of unknown force. Now how to identify this member force is tensile or compressive? So if the answer we get positive, then we can say that the member is compressive in nature, and if we get answer is negative, then we can say that this force is a tensile in nature. And when while you go for the next joint, you have to consider the correct nature of known force. Understand? So when we go for the next joint, and suppose at this joint we know the value of one of the member force which we calculated earlier, so we have to see the nature of that member force, whether it is a compressive or tensile. So if it is a compressive, then in next joint you have to show its arrow towards the joint, and suppose it is a tensile, then you have to show its arrow away from the joint. So similarly, the above process is repeated for all the joints one by one, and you have to find the member forces. So here I am solving a simple problem of a truss, how to find the member force. So here we know the first step is calculate the support reaction. Okay, because entire truss we are saying that it is a concurrent, non-concurrent. Entire truss is a non, we are considering non-concurrent. Okay, so we are applying these three conditions: summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy is equal to 0, and summation of moment is equal to 0. So when there is a problem, so you have to draw the diagram as it is. Then we can say that this truss is supported at A and C. So C support is a roller support and A support is a hinged support. So we see earlier in beam reaction, when the load which is coming on the truss is vertical, okay, so the reaction at this hinge support is also vertical. So here I am writing RA. Now the reaction at roller support also vertical, so here I am writing, here you have to write RC, sorry, this is RC reaction. Now one by one, so first we will take moment condition at point A or at hinge support. So summation m a is equal to 0 is equal to, this is a 4 into from the distance of this 4 kilonewton from a is 1 meter. So 4 into 1 plus 2 into the distance from a of 2 kilonewton position, this 2 plus 1 3, and it is rotated in clockwise direction, so plus, and minus rc into 4. So we will get rc 2.5 kilonewton. The next condition is summation fy is equal to 0. So ra minus 2 minus 4 plus rc. So from that we will get ra 3.5 kilonewton. So this is about the first step. Now what is the second step? Second step is we have to select a joint which having only two unknowns, and then we have to draw its free body diagram. So here you can see, so first I will select a joint A which having only two unknowns. So you can see this is joint A, okay, and these are at joint A which forces are coming, that is the reaction RA, then the member AB, and the force in member AB I can write as FAB, then the force in member AE I can write as FAE. Now second step is, for convenience assume all unknown forces acting towards joint that is compressed. Now these two members are unknown forces, so I assume these are compressive, so I mark its arrow towards the joint. Now this is an inclined member, so I am resolve this member. This is FA cos 60 and this is FA sin 60. Now this free body diagram is formed. Now this is a concurrent force system. Now we are applying the condition of equilibrium. So first I will take condition summation FY is equal to 0 is equal to RA minus FA sin 60. This is FA sin 60. So from that I am getting FA is equal to plus 4.04. So again, in previous step, so when the answer is positive, we are saying that this is compressive in nature. So in bracket, we have to write compressive. The next condition is summation Fx is equal to 0. That is FAE minus FAB, because it acting towards left, and minus FA cos 60. So from that I am getting FA is equal to minus 2.02 kilonewton. So when the answer is negative, I am saying that this member is tensile in nature. Similarly, I am taking second joint which having two unknown, so I am taking C. And if I draw a free body diagram, that is at C, which forces are acting? This is reaction RC. The force in member BC, that is FBC. The force in member CD I am writing as FCD. Now, these are unknown forces, so I am mark or assume these members are compressive. That is, I am marking the arrow direction towards the joint. Now, and this is the inclined member, so I am resolve this member force FCD cos 60 and this is FCD sin 60. Now apply condition of equilibrium. So from summation FY is equal to 0, so I am getting RC minus FCD sin 60. So I am getting FCD 2.88 kilonewton. So answer is positive, so I can say that this is a compressive in nature. The next condition is a summation fx is equal to 0. So from summation fx is equal, I am getting fcd f plus fcb plus fcd cos 60, because these two member forces are acting towards, right? So it is a plus. So from that I am getting fcb is equal to minus 1.44 kilonewton. So minus means this member force is tensile in nature. The next joint is, I am taking here B joint, because if I am select this A joint, I am getting these two member force. When I select this C joint, I am getting these two member force. Now when I am selecting this B joint, so I have to calculate only these member forces, that is F BE and F BD, because and the member force AB and BC already we have calculated. So we have to calculate only this member force FB and FBD. Now we have to draw the free body diagram for that. So here this is a free body diagram. So this is a member force FAB. Now this AB is tensile in nature. So I am showing its arrow direction away from the joint, as well as this member force FBC is also tensile nature, because we are already calculated in previous joint and its nature is tensile, so it is away from the joint. Now the FBD and FB are only unknown member force, so I am showing its arrow direction towards the joint. Now these are inclined, so I am resolve these member forces. You can see this, and when the free body diagram is complete, now I am applying the condition of equilibrium. So from first condition, summation fy is equal to 0, so I am getting minus fb sin 60, you can see in the free body diagrams, minus fbd sin 60. So from that I am getting first equation, that is fb is equal to minus fbd. Now from summation fx is equal to 0, I am getting minus fbd cos 60 plus fb cos 60 minus fba plus fbc. You can say minus fba and fbc. Now here minus fba or FAB. So when you get taking the value of this FAB, okay, so in earlier joint we are getting FAB as a negative value, so you don't take this negative value from this joint, you have to take only its value, don't consider its sign convention, because we are marking its correct nature. So you have to take only value, don't take it sign convention. Okay, so from that we are getting two member force, the value of two member force, that is FB will get plus 0.58, so plus means it is a compressive nature. Then FBD will get the minus 0.58, minus means it is a tensile in nature. Now the last joint we are taking, you have to take either E or D. So here I am taking E. Now in this D section, see here, now we know this, we are calculating this member force CD, as well as we are calculating this member force DB. So we have to calculate only this member force, that is DE. So I am draw a free body diagram. This is a D joint. So at this joint the forces which are acting, that is 2 kilonewton external force, then this DC member force, so which is we are calculating in joint number 2, and the nature of the member force DC comes compressive, so it is, so where I am showing its arrow towards the joint. Similarly, FDB, okay, again we are calculated, this is a known force, that is we are calculated in earlier, and its nature is tensile, so its arrow direction I am showing away from the joint. Only we calculate unknown forces FD, so I am show its arrow direction towards the joint, that is compressive. Now we are taking again two condition of equilibrium, summation Fy is equal to 0 and summation Fx. So here only one member force calculated, we have to calculate, so you have to take only this only one condition, that is summation Fx is equal to 0, so we will get the FD is equal to plus 1.73 kilonewton. Plus means it is compressive in nature. So in this way we have to calculate the member forces by considering each joint separately, and we have to draw the free body diagram, and then we have to apply the condition of equilibrium, and lastly we have to tabulate all the results. So here you can see this is tabulated result. You can see this is a tabulated result, so this is very important. So when there is a question in exam, so you have to do all the calculation, and at the last you have to tabulate all these results. This is member force and its nature. So in this way we have to calculate the member forces. Now we'll see next example. So I am not taking in detail, so just I am explaining how to calculate the member forces. So you can see this is problem number 24, so on page number 152. So you can see this is a truss, it is a regular truss, and this truss is supported at B and A. Okay, at B there is a roller support, at A there is a hinge support. Now the load, external load which is coming on the truss, is one is vertical and one is inclined. So because of this inclined load, the reaction comes at hinge support is inclined. So we will mark its component. This is VA and this is HA. Okay, similarly the reaction at roller support B, I am writing as RB. Okay, now this is an inclined force, so I am going to resolve. So this is 50 sine 30 and this is 50 cos 30, because this 50 kilonewton makes an angle 30 degree with vertical, so this component will be sine, this component will be cross. Now we have to, first step is we have to calculate reaction, so first we have to take condition moment of forces about point A is equal to 0 is equal to, the first is, yeah, you can calculate from first condition, you will get which reaction, you will get RB. From summation Fy is equal to 0 is equal to, from that you will get the reaction component VA. Okay, and from summation Fx is equal to 0 is equal to, from that you will get reaction HA. Okay, and from you have to calculate what, RA. So we'll see the first condition, summation MFA is equal to 0, see here. So we can write as 40 into this 1.5, and it is a clockwise in nature. Then this 50 cos 30 into 3 plus 1.5, that is into 4.5. again this is clockwise. Now moment for this force, 50 sin 30, okay, into the this distance 3, and it is minus, and minus RB, because in minus RB into 6. So from that we will get what? RB. So summation FY is equal to 0, how will get VA? This is VA minus 40 minus 50 cos 30 plus RB. So from that we will get VA. So HA will get, summation FX is equal to 0, will get HA minus 50 sin 30 is equal to 0, will get HA, and from HA array will get what, from HA and VA will get reaction at E. Now the first part is complete. Now we'll go, next part is we go for the member force calculation. So when we go for member force calculation, now we'll see in this truss the angles are not given. So first you have to calculate the angle. So for how you calculate angle A, so I am calculating angle A. So angle A, how are you calculating? So tan inverse of, sorry, this so here say this is theta 1 is equal to, say this is theta 1 is equal to tan inverse of, the height is 3, okay, that is y is 3, x is 1.5, so you will get 3 by 1.5. So you have to calculate what will this angle. Similarly, you have to calculate this theta 2 in same manner, tan inverse of this 3 divided by this 1.5, you will get theta 2. This will be theta 2, okay, and this will be also theta 1. So once you calculate the angle, then you go for the member force analysis. So first, second step is, we have to select a joint which having only two unknowns. So first I will select a joint A, so first I will select joint A and I have to draw the free body diagram. So see here how I draw free body diagram. See here the free body diagram. So first joint A, so first I will mark the axis here, okay. Now I will draw the members. So this is member AD and this is member AC. So I write here the force in member AC, I am writing FAC. Then force in member AD is equal to, I am writing FAD. Now you are calculating this angle theta 1, earlier you are calculating, then this VA, okay, and HA is, again you have to write here HA. Okay, now these are now two unknowns, right? So initially you have to assume these are compressive in nature. So I am showing its arrow direction towards the joint. Now then you have to resolve this member force, okay. You have to write a component, and this will be FAD cos theta 1, this will be FAD sin theta 1, okay. Then you have to apply your conditional equilibrium. So first apply summation Fy is equal to 0 condition. So you will get member force FAD. Okay, you have to see whether it is a plus or minus. If it is a plus, then you have to write your compressive. If it is a minus, then you have to write it is a tensile in nature. Then next condition is summation Fx is equal to 0 is equal to, and from summation Fx is equal to 0 is equal to, you will get which member? FAC. So you will get FAC. Understand? So in this way you have to calculate the member force. So when I select a joint A, I am getting these two member force. Then I am selecting second joint B. I will draw the free body diagram for B so that I am getting these two member force. That is okay. So see here how to draw the free body diagram at P. Second at B. So if I will draw a free body diagram, if I draw free body diagram. This is B. Now the forces which are acting at B, this is reaction RB. RB, then the two members. Okay. Now, initially we have to assume these members are compressive. So I am showing its arrow direction toward the joint. Now, which are these two members? BC and BE. So I am right here. Member force in BC, I am right F. BC, member force in right B, I can write FBE. Now you know the angle here theta 2, you are calculated. Then you have to resolve this member force. Okay, you have to write the components of member force here, that is FB sin theta 2, here FB cos theta 2. And when the free body diagram is complete, you have to apply the condition of equilibrium. So first apply condition summation Fy is equal to 0 is equal to, so you will get which member force? FBE. Okay, so it will get either plus or minus. If it is a plus, you have to write compressive. If it is a minus, then you have to write tensile. The next condition is summation Fx is equal to 0. The next condition is summation Fx is equal to 0. So from that I am getting which member force? FBC is equal to, so from that again you will get either plus or minus. If it is plus, it is a compressive. It is a minus, then it is tensile. Okay, the next I am taking joint D. So I am going to draw a free body diagram for joint D. Joint D, so first I will mark the axis here. So D joint, Now I'll draw the external force here, which is 40 kilonewton. Okay, then I will draw the member here. This member inclined, okay, and this member is FAD. So I am writing here FAD, and this FAD we are calculated in joint force, and this is compressive nature. So, and this is a known force. So, as it is a compressive force, so I am sure its arrow direction towards the joint. Now, there are two unknowns here. Which one is? The member force CD and the member force DE. So, I draw, this is members. So this is F DE and this is F DC. Now DC, these are unknown, so I am showing its arrow direction toward the joint. Okay, now this angle is theta 1, opposite angles. Now this is inclined member, so we have to resolve these two members. Okay, now the free body diagram is complete. So apply the condition of equilibrium. So we will get the first condition, summation Fy is equal to 0 is equal to, okay, so from that I am getting which member force, FDC. So we will get member force DC. So whether you will get either plus or minus, so from plus it is a compressive, minus tensile. The next is summation fx is equal to 0. Okay, and when you take summation fx is equal to 0, we will get this member force, that is FDE plus or minus. It will be plus compressive, minus will get tensile. Now the next joint here, if I take a joint D, I am getting these two member forces. Now which member force is remains here? This member force is remains. So now I am taking which joint? E joint. Now I am going to draw the free body diagram for this E joint here. So first I will mark the external force 50 kilonewton. Okay, this is inclined, so I am resolve this. This is 50 sine 30. This vertical is 50 cos 30. Okay, I will mark the members. So one more member is, this is inclined member, which is calculated earlier, that is member force. See here, member force BE. So I am writing here FBE. Okay, now this FBE member force is already calculated in second joint, and its nature is compressive, so I am show its arrow towards the joint. The next is this member, and this member is DE. F D E, and this we have to see its nature. So actually we will get F D is a compressive, so it is, we are, I am showing its arrow direction towards the joint. Now only one member is unknown, that is this member. Okay, and so that I am assuming that this unknown force is compressive in nature, and this member is FCE. FCE. Now you have to resolve these forces F, okay, as well as this, you have to resolve this member force. Now the free body diagram is complete, you can see this. Now you have to apply only one condition, only summation Fy is equal to 0. So you can apply only one condition, summation Fy is equal to 0, so you will get member force FCE. So in this way you will calculate all member forces, and at the last you have to tabulate all the member forces. Okay, in a table you have to write the member, then you have to write the force, and add the last column you have to write its nature. So you have to write member, it is the value of the forces, and you have to write the nature, whether it is a compressive or tensile. So in this way you have to calculate the member forces in the truss by method of joint. The next, you can see this, this is on page number 154. So this is a regular truss. Again the E joint is a roller, E joint is a hinged. Again external force, two vertical, one horizontal. So because of this horizontal force, the reaction at this joint, A joint will be inclined. So I am writing here two components, this is VA, this is HA. Okay, this is roller support, so this is, I can write as this is a reaction. So this is your first step, that you have to calculate the support reaction. The second step is you have to select a joint which having only two unknowns. So first I will select joint A, so that I am getting these two member ports, that is FAC and FAB. Then second I am select the joint E, so I am getting two member force, that is FEC and FED. The third joint I am selecting B, so I am getting the two member force, that is FBD and FBC, and the member force BA we are calculating in joint number 1. And the last fourth joint I am selecting joint D, and we have to calculate only member force DC, because the member force DB were calculated earlier here, and member force DE were calculated in joint number 2. So in this way you have to calculate all the member forces, and you have to tabulate all the result. So again this one is the same, that is on page number 156. The problem is, again this is a truss, the two vertical loads, external loads which are coming on the truss. So because of two vertical loads, the reaction at hinge support also goes vertical. So I am writing here RA, then this is reaction RB. Then Second part is the first sorry the first step is you have to calculate the support reaction. So you have to take first condition of moment of forces about A. So you will get which reaction RB. So from summation Fy is equal to 0, you will get reaction RE. Now when you go for the member force calculation, you have to calculate first angle here. So first you have to calculate angle theta 1 here. Okay, so theta 1 will be tan of inverse 6/4. So please you have to calculate angles with help of the calculator. Okay, then theta 2, you have to calculate angle here. Theta 2 is equal to tan of inverse 8/4. You have to calculate angle with help of the calculators here. This theta 2 and this theta 2 will same. Okay, now again you have to calculate angle for this part. This is theta 3 and this theta 3 is equal to tan of inverse y by x. So this will be 2, because this 8 minus 6, this will be 2 meter, and this horizontal distance will be 6 plus 4 10. So theta 3 will be 2/10. So that when you get angle here theta 3, so the angle for this member CD will be theta 3. So you can easily resolve this member CD. Okay, once you get the angles, the next part is member force calculation. So first you have to take this joint A, so that you will get these two member force FAC and FAE. This is joint number one. Then you have to take joint two, this that is B, so that you will get member force FBE and FBD. Then you have to take the third joint C, so you will get two member force, that is FCD and FCE. The F member force FCA or AC you are calculated in joint number one, and the last member force, the last joint you have to take, that is joint D. So in that you have to calculate only this member force, that is FDE, because already this member force CD and DE you are calculated in joint number 3 and joint number 2 respectively. So in this way you have to calculate the member force in a truss. So this is about the regular truss. Now when again this is a truss. So here again this is a roller support, this is hinge support, so the external load is vertical, so the reaction at hinge support is go vertical. So this is RD reaction, then this is roller support reaction, this is RC. Okay, first calculate reaction, second you have to calculate the angles. Okay, then next one by one you have to start for member force calculation. So the second step is you have to select a joint or any support which having only tonneau. So first I will take joint D. So I am getting these two member force FDA and FDC. Then second I am taking joint A, so I am getting the two member force, that is FAB and FAC. And at the last I am taking which joint? Joint B. So I will get member force FBC. So in this way, you have to do the member force calculation. So this is about the regular truss. When there is a cantilever truss, means one part of the truss is fixed and other part is free. So when there is a fixed cantilever truss, there is a no need to calculate the reaction here. That is the first step. Now we directly start from step number 2. So what is the step number 2? So first you have to select a joint which having only two arms. So when we see in the truss, so which joint has two unknowns? Can you see here? Okay, that is joint E. Here this E joint has two unknowns. So first I am taking this joint E. I will draw the free body diagram. Okay, see here again. I will draw free body diagram here. So this is 6 kilonewton. If the angles are not given, you have to calculate the angles. Remember, now the members, this is one member, this is one member. So member is F E B, this is F E D. Now these are unknowns, so I am showing its arrow direction towards the joint, that is compressed. So once you get the free body diagram, apply condition of equilibrium. Okay, so when you apply condition of equilibrium, so first condition, summation Fy is equal to 0. So from summation Fy is equal to 0, I am getting the member force Fed. Okay, and from summation Fx is equal to 0. Okay, so from that I am getting member force Fe. P. Okay, so I am getting two member poles, that is FED and FEB. Okay, the next joint, now tell me which, that is I am getting these two member poles FEB, ED and FEB. Now tell me which second joint, which joint I have to take second. So joint D, because in the D joint there are three members FDE, FDB, FDC. So already we have calculated this member D. So there are only two unknowns, this FCD and FDB. So you have to draw free body diagram of this joint D. Apply two conditions, summation Fy is equal to 0, summation Fx is equal to 0, then you will get these two member forces. Okay, the third joint you are taking B, right? So when you take the joint D, so this member force BD is already calculated in D joint. Now only there are two unknowns. This is FBC and FBA. Apply two conditions, summation Fy is equal to 0 and summation Fx is equal to 0. You can easily calculate member force FBC and member force FBA or AB. Understand? So you have to calculate the member force in this way for the cantilever truss. So this is a fixed cantilever truss, that is one part is fixed and another is free. But in fixed cantilever truss, we are not calculating the reactions. Okay, but sometimes the in cantilever truss, you can see the truss is supported on roller support and hinge support. So in that case, we have to calculate reaction here. So now this is a roller support, so I show it, the reaction is a, so what is the nature of the reaction at roller support? Perpendicular to the plane of roller. So this is a reaction RE, and this is hinge support. So we have to show two components, this is HA component and this is VA component. Okay, so your first step is calculate reaction Okay, means you have to calculate RE reaction and you have to calculate RA reaction. Okay, then second, member force calculation means you starts from a joint which having only two unknowns. So I am starts from here, that is point C. So when I select a point C, I will draw its free body diagram. Okay, and then I am applying two conditions, summation Fy is equal to 0 and summation Fx is equal to 0. So when I am taking summation Fy is equal to 0, I am getting this member force FCB, and when I am taking summation Fx is equal to 0 condition, I am getting this member force FC. This is joint number 1. So second joint I am taking B joint. Okay, so that at B joint there are three members, F B A, okay, F B D and F B C. So F B C we are already calculated in previous joint. Now only we have to calculate these two member forces, that is F B A and F B D. Okay, the next joint I am taking D joint. So at when I draw free body diagram for D joint, okay, you can see this at D which forces are acting, the 2000 newton, then member force F D E, the member force F D A, the member force F D B, and the member force F DC. Okay, so FDB and FDC are already calculated member forces. Only these two member force, that is FDA and FDE, are unknown. So we have to calculate only two unknown force, and these two unknown force we have to calculate by using these two condition of equilibrium. Okay, and the last member force remaining is F AE. So you have to select either A joint or you have to select either E joint. So you will get this member force AE. So in this way, you have to calculate member force for cantilever truss. So in this way, you have to calculate the member forces of a truss by using the method of joint. So for any doubts or any queries, so you can contact me on WhatsApp. Okay, you have my WhatsApp number, so you can either call me, okay, or you have to take a picture, okay, and you have to send me on WhatsApp group. Okay, so I can help you. But you have to carefully see this lecture and you have to try to solve these problems at home. Okay, these are very very easy problems, so you don't worry about it. Okay, so yeah, just you have to go practicing how to calculate the member forces. Okay, thank you.